what's cooking, people? Well, there's been a ton of news today, huh? The Switch selling nearly 18 million in its first year, which is fantastic. First-party software breaking Nintendo records based off previous entries in popular series. As someone pointed out on Twitter, Star Fox 2 for the SNES has sold 5.28 million. Thanks to the SNES Mini, actually selling that amount. But then I guess, all other software our platform has sold that much too, We saw the placeholder logo for the new Sonic the Hedgehog movie. A movie I have little to no faith in whatsoever. Just your usual foolish sliver of hope that something Sonic related might actually be good this time around. We just got confirmation that the next Splatfest for Splatoon 2 will be the Teenage Mutant Hero Turtles themed, and yes, in the UK it was called Hero Turtles for us, and I fully agree that Ninja Turtles was a much better name. But you'll be choosing between Raphael and Leonardo, who's the better turtle, I guess, which is, for me, neither, because I always was a Michelangelo fan. Then I actually preferred Donatello second, and then Leonardo, mostly because he had two swords, which is also is always cool. But I did prefer Raphael's personality over Leonardo's. But when it comes to the Splatfest, I'll be Team Leonardo. And I'd like to say that I think the new turtle designs are pretty trash. am I being nostalgic for the older design? But I still think the new design is worse than the old ones. but anyway, the biggest news coming out of all the news from today, I feel, is once again the shakeup of Nintendo management, and how we are now essentially looking at the next 20 years, based on people's ages, of Nintendo, with its new younger generation of managers and creators, and how the old guard is slowly passing the torch. A torch I feel is in good hands, based off everything we've seen in the last few years. So, Nintendo's new president, replacing the short tenure of the most serious looking man you've ever seen in your life, Mr. Tatsumi Kimishima, the man who has the type of look I want to master from when my daughters start dating, and those fools knock my door and I answer looking like this. scare the crap out of those fools, right? Mr. Kimishima, as we know, was only brought in for the short term to oversee the launch of the Nintendo Switch, whose plans were set in motion by the late, great, and truly sorely missed Mr. Satoru Iwata. I still get a feeling of sadness every time I mention his name. I think for many of us, like I said before, he became not only the face of Nintendo, but Nintendo itself in physical form. And since he's been gone, something just hasn't been the same. I still feel the same way about Michael Jackson. When he died, a part of music for me died that day, as well. And as for movies, the same happened when Robin Williams died. All these people, without a doubt, having big impacts on my life, and they'll be forever missed. But enough mourning the past, right? We keep moving forwards, and that's exactly what Nintendo are doing, moving forwards. And they are doing this by moving their younger as well as experienced employees up the ranks to positions that greatly affect Nintendo's future. And this is where their new president, Shuntaro Furukawa, I hope I pronounced that right, steps in. Now I'm not sure about anyone else, but this is the first time in my memory that I've ever heard of this guy. I'm not going to sit here and pretend like some people that I know every Nintendo employee out there. As like with many of these big companies, if your name or face isn't plastered everywhere in the credits or on screen or whatever, the chances are you will probably go unnoticed for the most part. So Mr. Furukawa, soon after being announced as Nintendo's new president, with Mr. Kimishima remaining in an advisory role for the moment, came out and gave a pretty bold, as well as straight to the point response during an interview, which was this, and I quote, "We will develop the company to its fullest. I will balance Nintendo's traditions, originality, and flexibility. I grew up playing the Famicom and come from that generation. Now, as a member of management with Super Mario's creator Shigeru Miyamoto, I have a lot of respect for him. On the other hand, with this new job, that can't just be it. So I expect to say that what needs to be said to run the company." there are some key things in here which I'd like to briefly talk about. First is him confirming the usual company stance of "we will develop the company to its fullest," which we hear all the time, right? Then after that, he says, "I will balance Nintendo traditions, originality, and flexibility." What I took from this was the "I" part. You could look at this in a few ways. I feel him being assertive in his new role, showing that he has management-like material, which I'm sure he does. Otherwise he wouldn't be given this position. Or you can look at it from as a firm foot on the floor, with him almost perhaps pointing out that there is a lack of balance at the moment in Nintendo's output. Something I think we can all agree on in many areas. And now he's going to be the one to sort it out where arguably others might have failed. I feel something very bold to say, but like I said, there is absolutely reasons why this man, I've never heard of, has now been moved into the seat of power within the Big N. Then he goes on to confirm his connection to video games, his long history, because he's been playing games since the Famicom, which is the NES to many of us. I think it's clear here that he's making sure people know that he's been playing games since Nintendo's first system, so he knows games as much as the next person. And in a separate note, he does also confirm his favourite game of late being Golf Story, an indie title that has sold pretty well on the Nintendo Switch. And him clearly showing again that he's still involved in playing games himself. And not only that, recent and arguably quirky ones, that I feel the man is basically telling us, I've been there since the start and I'm still playing. Good news for those gamers who have grown to love these higher-ups who aren't just men in suits, but men who love the industry they are in and actively take part in it. Now, here comes the real juicy part I found. As I quoted earlier, and I'm going to leave this quote on the screen for a while as I talk about it, he goes on to say that now he's a member of the management with Super Mario's creator Shigeru Miyamoto. I found that really strange, actually, how he pointed that out. Maybe out of name recognition for the masses, or perhaps even once again making a statement. He continues to say that he has a lot of respect for Miyamoto, but then says, on the other hand, with this new job, respect can't be enough. So I expect to say what needs to be said to run the company. I'm not sure about anyone else here, but I saw this as a holy shit. This man just rolls up, lets Miyamoto know where he stands, and now new Nintendo president Mr. Shuntaro Furukawa is the man in charge. And if I say lick the toe jam out from between my toes because I believe this will save Nintendo, then I'm going to ask or tell you to. You understand? maybe I'm exaggerating here, but still, there are, I feel, pretty direct words and ones that show that some of the old guards are not only passing the torch but willing to work with or sometimes under the new guard. Now, whether Miyamoto has been pretty strict in the past when it comes to his thoughts towards the direction Nintendo should go in, with both their hardware and software, are things we might just never know. You know, things we hear rumors of sometimes, you know, some confirmed, you know, to be able to turn over tables that we hear rumors of. You know, but behind closed doors, you know, our beloved creator of some of the greatest characters and games we've ever had the pleasure of experiencing, behind closed doors, Miyamoto could be a bad motherfucker. You know, you smell me? Now, Mr. Furukawa is like, you know, I told that fool Wii Music was a bad idea. You know, now it's time for me to put a stop to this nonsense. You know, joking aside, there will come a day when Miyamoto retires, you know, or Crom forbids passes away, and you know, if I'm also still walking this earth, Crom winning as well, it will be an incredibly sad day for me, this industry and Nintendo. You know, but I think it's clear, you know, what's going on here. The new Nintendo, which has been brewing for some time now, is starting to take shape. The new Nintendo that will see us most likely through, you know, the next 20 years. You know, alongside this, Satoru Shibata, who was Nintendo of US president, is also stepping down from his role and moving to Nintendo HQ in Japan to also join the board of directors. And then we have some familiar faces getting promotions, much deserved ones, I feel. Mr. Takahashi Tezuka, a man if you're a Nintendo fan, you know, then you need no introduction to. And Mr. Yoshiaki Koizumi, one of the most pimp-looking mofos on the planet, a Nintendo veteran and arguably the face of the Nintendo Switch generation of Nintendo, seen, you know, as he helped design it. Nintendo are in good hands, and we have to remember, you know, we've been gobbling up the new Nintendo for years, you know, as well of late, because this Nintendo has brought us games like Mario Kart 8, The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild, Super Mario Odyssey, Splatoon 1 and 2, and ARMS, just to name a few. Then will come a time when the people who made Nintendo, the Nintendo that we love today, they'll have to move on and leave a younger generation to carry on a torch. You know, a torch, thanks to the success of the Switch and recent software, is burning brightly. And I have no fears whatsoever. I'm excited to see the future of Nintendo and have no fears that they'll keep on surprising us and delighting us through every generation, as well as making us scream with frustration on why the Virtual Console isn't here yet. Stupid Nintendo, come on already. Anyway, let me know your thoughts on all this, and you know, if you manage to stay to the end, thanks for listening. Peace.